the solution for this example. So we have our data here, impact and likelihood of the various risks. Now for an XY chart, you mustn't highlight the first part. We'll get to that just now. We can highlight these two. I'll say insert. And you'll see over here, we've got a scatter. When I click on it, we get something that looks like that. Now just to make your life a bit easier, it's quite useful right up front to specify what the axes mean, because you can see here they've just got the listing. So we know the X or horizontal axis is impact. I'm just going to go to design, add an axis title, and I'm going to say the horizontal one, I want to call that impact. The vertical one, I'm going to call it likelihood. So we've got those set up. Let's just make it a bit bigger. What we now want to do as well is get the names in here. So in the more recent versions of Excel, so Excel 2013 onwards, I can right click on that. I'm going to add labels, so I'm going to right click and say add data labels, and you'll see for now it just puts a number in, but we don't want that. I'm gonna just click on it, and if I come look here and look at the label options, for now it's only showing us the Y value. We could obviously put the X value on as well, but better than any of those is I want values from cells, and I wanted to rather put the risk name on there. Get rid of the Y values. So what you can see is that now it's shown, and you can see it's shown to the right of the points. You can obviously decide, do you want it above, below, right, left, etc. So we've got that. That looks pretty good. But now we want to show an axis that crosses here and here to show us the middle points. So in order to do this, I can then right click on the axes. I'm going to say format the axes, and you'll see here the horizontal axis crosses at automatic, or, and I'm going to go in here and I'm going to say it crosses at the point, the fifth point, 5. You'll see immediately moves up. It's not quite clear enough, so I'm just going to go here and I'm going to say that this line must maybe be a solid line. You can see it's more solid. Maybe it should be a little bit thicker. And maybe the dash, there should be a dash type there, something to that effect. You'll see as well that the what's not ideal here is that the numbers are right up here, so we're going to say rather let the labels appear low. You'll see they appear over here. Same thing now to get a line going upwards. I'm going to right click on the horizontal axis, say format axes. What we're now going to say is that the vertical axis, this, must cross at 0.5 as well. So you'll see now it goes to 0.5. Just going to click on that axis, and we're going to say the label position, again, I don't like it here in the middle of everything. So we're going to say low, so you'll see it moves to the left. And again, it's not exactly very obvious that it's there. So we're going to go to a line, we're going to say it's a solid line. Let's make it a little bit thicker, maybe a 2, and maybe we can put a dash type in again. So now what you've got is you've got a XY axis with all your risks. You can label them, give them a specific name, and they'll appear on your risk register.